Have you ever wondered why you were rejected in that job interview? Or perhaps why you were teased at college or lack self-confidence? Well, the answer is easy. According to a few advertisements, it's because you're not fair-skinned. It's no surprise that we as a country have always been obsessed with fair skin. From ogling at fair-skinned people as they walk past us to belittling dark skin as inferior, all of this has set a very unhealthy beauty standard. In fact, headlines like these are not new to India. But here's what's worse. This unhealthy obsession of ours has helped support an entire industry that feeds off this insecurity. Colourism, or discrimination on the basis of colour, is very rampant in India. Instances of colourism is seen in movies, song lyrics, photo shoots of models, and ads. In fact, even matrimonial websites specify that brides must be fair. Now, this kind of mindset was heavily promoted by advertisers to sell off their products. In fact, take a look at these series of advertisements that promote that having lighter skin can give you higher chances of getting a good job, a marriage proposal, and overall success in life as compared to people with darker skin. The skin lightening industry was estimated to be over 450 million in value in 2017 and was projected to grow over 2.4 billion by 2020. That is until the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare finalized on the Drugs and Magic Remedies Objectionable Advertisement Amendment Bill. Under this bill, advertisements that promote remedies for diseases like AIDS, deafness, and blindness, etc., were banned. This list also contains 54 such claims and was then extended to 78. The new regulation seeks to ban the promotion of fairness creams, anti-aging creams, health drinks that promote the rate of height and growth in children, and many more. Previously, Section 7 of the existing Act explains the penalty if convicted, wherein first-timers were penalized with a fine, a six-month imprisonment, or both, and subsequent conviction was penalized with a fine, a one-year imprisonment, or both. But here's the big change. The amendment has proposed a 5-year jail term and a 50 lakh fine for brands that don't comply with these rules. Now, this is a big win for India in its battle against colour discrimination. But will this be the final nail to the coffin against colourism?
Commercials in India like Fair and Lovely and all.
I don't like them, no.
I think they are just temporary things. Instead, like, you should have the inner glow, and that's what matters the most. I just feel that.
Everyone should be proud of their own skin tone. They should stop using fairness creams ad.
I feel that most people in India are already like dark skin colored, and it leads to a lot of social problems and depression and stress among girls and women who, and even men who don't feel that they are capable enough to get married or to get a spouse or be socially connected with people. And fairness cream ads just try to deteriorate and try to motivate that the fact that they're thinking is actually right.
So did you know recently there was a ban imposed on them? Anyone promotes a fairness cream ad, 50 lakhs fine and 5 years of jail. So do you think that India is finally heading into a good direction?
Yes, it's a really good initiative if it's been taken, because I feel that it's not a good ad. It's try to deteriorate the society mentality. It's not good.
But from business point of view, it would be a damage for them. But otherwise, I think that, yeah, it's a good thing.
So India is like basically growing in
Yes, I do feel so.
That's all we have for in today's show. I'm Neha Nambiar. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. And if you want to stay up to date with more debates like these, check out our last two videos right here. And until next time, always verify news before you share it online. Goodbye.